Alright, so in today's video, we're going to install some rock sliders on the Jeep, but decided to fire up the diesel heater in the garage. I've got it exhausted outside. It's totally safe. 9 minutes running, we're at 4 hertz. It's probably about 65%, maybe 70% throttle, let's say. And what I want to do is test in the heater what the temperature is coming out of this tube that I run when I camp. This tube goes into my tent, and I've got an infrared thermometer here, so we're going to use that to kind of test what it is. Wanted to see if it would heat up the garage a little bit, which it's like 55 degrees again today, so I don't have to worry about that. I also picked up this tube on Amazon. Now this is a 3-inch dryer tube, and it's insulated, so it's much thicker. It's got like a PVC liner. I want to see if this makes any difference with temperature loss between the tent and the unit. So, taking some quick readings here, right at the top, right at the base of this, it is 66 degrees. I don't know how accurate that is. We take this off and check the temperature at the unit right inside of there. It says it's 200 and, wow, it's actually burning my skin. It's 240 degrees plus. So that would tell me that this tube alone is a pretty good insulator, because if this tube is reading, you know, 80 degrees, 82 degrees, let's kind of follow it all the way up. About 3 feet away, it's 79 degrees, 77. This is a 10-foot hose. We're almost to the end. There's the end. We're at 71. Output temperature. It says it's about 180 degrees. I don't know how, I don't know if I trust that or not. But yeah, it's cranking, man. I mean, it's really hot in there, so there's a good chance that it might be over 100 plus degrees in there. So that tube is a pretty good insulator, I guess. So the myth of heat loss from the unit 10 feet away to here, the output, I'm gonna still call that a myth, but let's go ahead and put the other hose on and see what happens. This has been running for about 10 minutes now, so we'll give it that same amount of time and we'll start the test again. All right, so about 10 minutes again. Overall, this is about 9 minutes actually, but put the new insulated hose on, and it's not too bad. Let's see what our thermometer says here. Right out of this, 206, 194, a little further down, we're at 180, right in the middle, 185, 150, 150, what's my output? My output right inside. This is about the same, I guess. So is there a point to upgrade? Maybe not. Everybody says that the black plastic one's gonna smell more. It doesn't smell like anything. I don't smell the plastic melting or whatnot. It matches better, and it accordions down a lot nicer and kind of stays there a lot easier than this does. But is there a big difference, a big reason to upgrade? I don't really think so. I think it'll be just fine. I know there's a lot of people that want to see the heater, so pop the controller off, open it up. I line the top with some sound deadening material, so that the little pump you hear clicking down there doesn't, you know, it's not so loud. But there's the tank, heater, all the wiring, everything's good. I do use some galvanized aluminum at the bottom there as a heat shield for the exhaust pipe because it's kind of hot, but it doesn't get very hot in there. In fact, now that I have my thermometer, let's see. How hot does that exhaust get? That plate is about 280 degrees, 250, 280. So not bad. Not bad at all. So my final thoughts on this hose is I'm going to keep it. And here's why. When you accordion it down, it stays nice and tight. Whereas this hose, the dryer vent hose, if you accordion it, it springs right back up, which means packing this up is a lot harder to do than this. So this, I can accordion down to the original size, which was about 7 inches in length total from 10 feet, and it'll fit in the camping gear. Any one of the totes, a lot better. It'll fit in the truck. I mean, it might even fit in that box. I have no idea, but we're gonna go ahead and play with it and see what it does.